Good afternoon, everyone. I'm so excited to be with you all today celebrating you, and I want to welcome you to the School of Dentistry White Coat Ceremony. My name is Dr. Mercedes Porter, and I'm an Assistant Dean for Academic Affairs and a Clinical Associate Professor in the Division of Operative Dentistry. This afternoon, we've come together to welcome our newest members at the School of Dentistry into the oral health profession, which include our students in the dual degree Bachelor of Science in Dental Hygiene and Master of Dental Therapy Class of 2023, the Bachelor of Science in Dental Hygiene Class of 2022, and the Doctor of Dental Surgery Class of 2024. This afternoon's ceremony is meant to recognize your entry into our profession, punctuated with your commitment to professionalism and ethical practice. For decades now, clinically based health professional schools have used the distribution of the white coat to students as a symbol and a reminder of the responsibility and trust that is being granted upon you, and the expectation of the highest degree of professionalism that is expected of you as you embark upon this educational journey into the oral health profession. Students, your decision to become an oral health professional has led you to an educational path that is not granted to everyone. On the other side of the many exams, quizzes, papers, skills assessments, and late nights of study, you will enter into a career of providing care for patients, advocating for social justice and health policies, educating future oral health care professionals, discovering new treatment modalities, forging groundbreaking research, improving the overall health of your patients, and positively engaging and impacting the communities where you will reside. This afternoon, I want to congratulate you for all of your hard work and dedication thus far, and welcome you into this great profession. At this time, it is my great honor to introduce Dr. Keith Mays, Dean of the School of Dentistry. Dr. Mays has earned multiple certificates and degrees, including a master's and a PhD, and has held several academic and administrative leadership appointments at various institutions prior to joining the University of Minnesota in 2015 as the academic dean. This past June, he assumed the role of dean of the University of Minnesota School of Dentistry, and he currently serves as chair of the board for the American Dental Education Association. Please welcome Dr. Mays.
Thank you, Dr. Porter. Good afternoon, and thank you for supporting our students this afternoon with your presence at this wonderful rite of passage for our students. Last year, we were not able to have this ceremony, and I'm thrilled that, one, we can gather with our students, and two, that family, friends, and other guests can join us both in person or online today. It is my pleasure to welcome to you to our 2021 White Coat Ceremony that would actually have occurred in 2020 during the students' first semester. This ceremony marks an important milestone along your journey as a health professional student. The white coat is a standard of professionalism and caring and an emblem of trust, of the trust that must be earned from your patients. The White Coat Ceremony is a time-honored tradition of inducting students into the oral health professions. The first White Coat Ceremony took place on August 20th, 1993 at Columbia University College of Physicians and Surgeons in New York. The ceremony was instituted by Dr. Arnold Gold. Dr. Gold believed it was important for future health professionals to affirm the centrality of compassion and empathy for patients as the heart of healthcare. In the same spirit, the school's clinical curriculum enables dental hygiene, and dental therapy students to develop a broad understanding of overall health and the social responsibilities as oral health professionals that they will have to have in their communities that they are going to practice in. When you wear the white coat, you are demonstrating that you are someone that cares for those in need and seeks to make them whole through the application of science, caring, and clinical skill. The white coat symbolizes an affirmation that your purpose will be professional and ethical, and that you can be trusted to honor the tradition of this learned profession by placing the interests of your patients above your own. Today, you will take an oath that demonstrates your commitment to your patients and confers upon you the identity of a health professional. I am excited with you and for you today as you participate in this rite of passage in receiving your white coat. We who are gathered here in person or virtually bear witness to your commitment to care for your patients and their communities. Congratulations to each of you for reaching this milestone.
Thank you, Dr. Mays. Academic, personal, and professional integrity are the cornerstones of success in our profession. At the School of Dentistry, we want this message to come across to our students in a very personal way. And therefore, we ask every class, upon entering the school and beginning their professional careers, to create their own class code of ethics that is consistent with current university policies and ethical codes of professional organizations. Students work together as a class without any faculty input to develop their own interpretation of these codes. The result is a unique class statement that is aligned with the values, characteristics, and personality of each unique class. During our white coat ceremony today, each student is invited to sign their class code of ethics on stage to signify their personal commitment to professional ethics. After today's ceremony, these documents will be displayed in the School of Dentistry. The Master of Dental Therapy class of 2023 will be the first to present their code of ethics. Please welcome Missy Burgett and Rosemary Scriver to read their dental therapy class code of ethics.
The Dental Hygiene and Dental Therapy Dual Degree Class of 2023 devotes this code of ethics to our community members, peers, and our educators. Our code of ethics will serve to remind us of the key values of our educational practices and the emerging collaborative dental profession that is dental therapy. It is our duty to attest our promises and practices through empathy, integrity, inclusivity, as well as quality and ethical practices in an ever-changing world. To our patients. We promise to provide all patients with quality care that acknowledges and adapts to COVID-19 related concerns. As a whole, we will pursue the understanding of diverse communities, differentiating beliefs, and those with limited access to dental care. As dental therapists, we strive to provide exceptional care to patients while applying our extensive knowledge and skills.
To our fellow students, colleagues, and ourselves, we promise to encourage one another academically and clinically while remaining respectful, practicing transparent communication, and providing assistance to the best of our abilities. As dental therapists, we will strive to attain adequate knowledge and skills from our faculty and peers. We will remain dedicated to our highly dynamic career and the opportunities that we will be able to provide patients and other healthcare professionals. We pledge to further contribute to the expansion of dental therapy as a profession. Lastly, to our community, we promise to utilize our skill set to provide greater access to dental health professional shortage areas, minority communities, and underserved populations by prioritizing the equity of healthcare. We are devoted to creating a safe environment for all patients by promoting diversity and inclusion within the School of Dentistry, as well as beyond the walls of Moose Tower. We will be advocates for dental therapy as our profession is essential, valuable, and benefits the public health of our communities.
Thank you, ladies. We will now begin with the presentation of the White Coats, starting first with the Master of Dental Therapy students. Acknowledging their entry into the profession of oral health care providers, I would like to invite Dr. Carl Self, Director of the Division of Dental Therapy, Dr. Paul O'Lean, Interim Associate Dean for Clinical Affairs, and Dr. Keith Mays, Dean of the School of Dentistry, to take their places on stage to present the White Coats to the dual degree Master of Dental Therapy class of 2023. Students, we will ask you to please hold your applause until the last student in each class has received their coat. Missy Burgett, Lino Lakes, Minnesota, University of Wisconsin, River Falls. Karen Bird, Onalaska, Wisconsin, University of Minnesota, Duluth. Lucy Berkey, ISANT, Minnesota, Century College, St. Paul College. Gracie Camo, Wisconsin Rapids, Wisconsin, University of Wisconsin-Madison. Mai Anh Huang, Hanoi, Vietnam, University of Minnesota, Twin Cities. Rosemary Scriver, Wayland, Iowa, Central College. Welcome to you all. Let's give them a round of applause.
On behalf of the Division of Dental Therapy, I'd like to welcome all students here today into the dental profession. I'd also like to give a special congratulations to the Dental Therapy Class of 2023 as you continue your journey to become the newest members of the oral health care team. And I'd like to congratulate you for choosing a profession that is focused on improving health of underserved families and communities. I appreciate the thoughtful effort you put into writing your code of ethics, and your code will guide you well in your roles as students, providers, collaborators, educators, and ambassadors. Now, I would ask the Dental Therapy Class of 2023 to stand and join me in reciting the Minnesota Oath for Dental Therapists. In all I hold sacred, I publicly take this pledge to guide my practice in the profession for which I will be educated. Without discrimination, I will honor my patient's dignity, autonomy, and confidences, and will at all times provide respectful and informed counsel and care. I will recognize my strengths and limitations. I will seek to help and counsel of colleagues in the practice of dentistry when it is in the best interest of my patients. I commit to being a lifelong scholar, continuously improving and refining the skills I have acquired. I further commit myself to leadership in the community, to advancing access to dental care, and to serving all members of society while advancing the practice of dental therapy. The high regard of my profession is born of society's trust in its healthcare practitioners. I will strive to merit that trust. May all my actions reflect positively on myself, the University of Minnesota School of Dentistry, my community, and my chosen profession. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Self. We would now like to recognize our dental hygiene learners. Please welcome representatives from the Bachelor of Science in Dental Hygiene Class of 2022, Kayla Michalowski, Emily Nadeau, and Paige Teske, who will read their class code of ethics. As the dental hygiene class of 2022, we are dedicated to the growth of our own knowledge and skills, the success of our peers, and the betterment of our community and profession. This code of ethics highlights the importance of respect, collaboration, integrity, professionalism, and compassion throughout our time here at the University of Minnesota, and as we continue on to our careers. We pledge to our patients. We understand our words and actions impact people on a daily basis, so we want to implement honesty and confidentiality into our daily interactions. We will respect what others have to say, even when we disagree. We will have an environment where everyone feels comfortable, safe, and respected, despite their backgrounds or beliefs. Having concern and compassion for people around us while maintaining professional boundaries is an important aspect to fulfill.
We pledge to our colleagues, peers, and ourselves. We strive to work, grow, and learn as not only individuals, but also as a team. With this, we must emphasize having strong communications and productive collaborations. Further, our relationships and connections will open many new doors, full of new knowledge and skill, which we must appreciate and utilize to the best of our abilities. We understand that everyone goes through difficult times, and we aim to support each other in all aspects, both outside and within the School of Dentistry.
We pledge to our community. We are fully dedicated to bettering ourselves as both professionals and humans. We promise to continuously further our competence and to always use our knowledge to help and serve others. It is of the utmost importance that we navigate our future careers with integrity and professionalism. Our morals and values that we will have acquired from this program will guide us to embrace diversity and advocate for the dental community. With this code, we set high standards and intend to meet them throughout our time at the University of Minnesota and throughout our future careers.
Nice job, thank you. At this time, I will invite Dr. Cindy Stull, Director of the Division of Dental Hygiene, as well as Drs. Olin and Mays to take their places on the stage to present the white coats to the Bachelor of Science in Dental Hygiene class of 2022. Again, we ask for you to please hold your applause until the last student has received their coat. Mawardi Ali, Minneapolis, Minnesota, University of Minnesota, Twin Cities. Mariah Churchill, Lino Lakes, Minnesota, University of St. Thomas. Kaylin Dizell, Champlin, Minnesota, University of Minnesota, Twin Cities. Meret Seti, St. Paul, Minnesota, University of Minnesota, Twin Cities. Holly Henneman, Evansville, Minnesota, Minnesota State University, Mankato. Pelicherto Hare, Eagan, Minnesota, University of Minnesota, Twin Cities. Leja Jimenez, North Oaks, Minnesota, Minnesota State University, Mankato. Morgan Johnson, Coleraine, Minnesota, Minnesota State University, Mankato. Abby Larson, Waconia, Minnesota, Winona State University. Gwendolyn Lavelle, Minneapolis, Minnesota, Bethel University. Kayla Michalowski, Waupun, Wisconsin, University of Wisconsin-Milwaukee, Milwaukee Area Technical College. Iman Mohammed, Minneapolis, Minnesota, University of Minnesota, Twin Cities. Emily Nadeau, Columbus, Minnesota, University of St. Thomas. Ram Lanur, Minneapolis, Minnesota, University of Minnesota, Twin Cities. Christian Ramirez, West St. Paul, Minnesota, University of Minnesota, Twin Cities. Rachel Schwartz, Lakeville, Minnesota, University of Minnesota, Twin Cities. Kylie Schimmick, Rochester, Minnesota, University of Minnesota, Twin Cities. Paige Teske, Keel, Wisconsin, University of Wisconsin-Milwaukee, Fox Valley Technical College. Kyra Trader, Sioux Falls, South Dakota, University of Minnesota, Twin Cities. Sarah Vo, St. Paul, Minnesota, University of Minnesota, Twin Cities. And a warm welcome to all. Let's give them all a round of applause.
So I would like to first congratulate all of you on your decision to pursue dental hygiene as your career. I believe that this career is something that we are going to see change a lot in the next few years. So it's an exciting time, and I really look forward to seeing how all of you are going to shape our profession and lead the profession into the future. I would also like to congratulate you on the heartfelt words that you put into your code of ethics. And I encourage you, as you go into your future, into practice, that you revisit that on occasion to put that code of ethics into practice. And so now I would ask all of you to stand and join me in reciting the oath of the American Dental Hygienists Association. In my practice as a dental hygienist, I affirm my personal and professional commitment to improve the oral health of the public, to advance the art and science of dental hygiene, and to promote high standards of quality care. I pledge continually to improve my professional knowledge and skills, to render a full measure of service to each patient entrusted to my care, and to uphold the highest standards of professional competence and personal conduct in the interests of the dental hygiene profession and the public it serves.
Thank you, Dr. Stull. At this time, I would like to introduce Mitchell Bunting and Sarah Henry, members of the Doctor of Dental Surgery Class of 2024, to read their class code of ethics.
As the University of Minnesota Doctor of Dental Surgery Class of 2024, we pride ourselves upon maintaining resilience, compassion, and competitiveness while remaining resolute in our call to serve those around us. We recognize the duty laid before us to be active and upstanding members of the healthcare community. While this is a lifelong and all-consuming role, we are honored to accept it for the betterment of ourselves, our peers, and our communities. It is for these reasons we pledge the code of ethics written below. We pledge to ourselves to maintain competency through continued education during school and far after we graduate. Integrity and honesty will remain at the forefront of our practice and drive our self-awareness and humility while treating our patients. Through our journey, we aim to preserve our resiliency in the face of any challenges with unwavering confidence and desire to fulfill our duty. We shall hold ourselves accountable to pave new paths of innovation and discovery while respecting the foundations laid by those before us in the dental profession.
We pledge to our peers to develop a sense of belonging and in doing so, foster mutual respect rooted in empathy, compassion, and inclusivity. We will hold each other accountable to maintain the high standards created by our predecessors at the University of Minnesota School of Dentistry. We seek to maintain optimism and continually strengthen the community of healthcare professionals around the world by celebrating successes and learning from our failures. Open-mindedness and willingness to listen will enrich our interactions as peers, friends, and lifelong colleagues. We pledge to our community to remain lifelong educators of the best practices and interventions of oral health for everyone, from the underserved to the affluent, and to advocate for the betterment of both oral health care policy and infrastructure alike. Patient-centered care will drive our actions and recommendations as dental health professionals and confidants. We will treat every patient with respect and understanding for unique experiences, with the hope of improving their interactions with any dental health professional and the oral health of all that we encounter. It is during these trying and uncertain times that we vow to remain steadfast of these pledges throughout our education, beginning during the COVID-19 pandemic and reaching far beyond our statement as doctors of dental surgery. We, as a class, believe that these never-before-seen circumstances will create an adaptable nature and synergistic attitude among us that will hold true throughout our time as dental professionals. While we remain physically distant, we are focused on creating a sense of collective togetherness amongst ourselves, our peers, and our communities. Thus, we wholeheartedly support these pledges and genuinely sign our code of ethics.
Well done, thank you both. I once more invite Dr. Olean and Dr. Mays to the stage to present white coats to the Doctor of Dental Surgery Class of 2024. Yasmin Ahmed, Milwaukee, Wisconsin, Emory University. Bryce Allen, Maple Grove, Minnesota, University of St. Thomas. Amber Altendorf, Goodhue, Minnesota, University of Wisconsin, La Crosse. Matthew Anderson, Fall Creek, Wisconsin, Minnesota State University, Moorhead. Nicholas Falls, Perham, Minnesota, North Dakota State University. Megan Bonmiller, Great Falls, Montana, Montana State University. Riley Baumgartner, Anoka, Minnesota, University of St. Thomas. Shannon Bolio, Edina, Minnesota, University of Wisconsin-Madison. Clotilde Bechtel, Elk River, Minnesota, Liberty University. Sophia Birkenpass, Coon Rapids, Minnesota, University of Minnesota, Morris. Callan Bach, Eden Prairie, Minnesota, St. Olaf College. Lynn Braun, Mankato, Minnesota, University of Wisconsin-Madison. Amy Broll, Waconia, Minnesota, Winona State University. Mitchell Bunting, Buffalo, Minnesota, University of Wisconsin, La Crosse. Joe Bergmeyer, Mason City, Iowa, Concordia College. Jonathan Cochran, Wild Rose, Wisconsin, Luther College. The following student is unable to join us today, but we would like to recognize her. Taylor Cooper, Rochester, Minnesota, Winona State University. Mary Kramers, Grand Forks, North Dakota, North Dakota State University. Carson Dennis, Grand Forks, North Dakota, University of Minnesota, Twin Cities. Amber Drivdahl, Hobson, Montana, Carroll College. Zachary Dukleth, Dilworth, Minnesota, North Dakota State University. Cynthia Duta, Quinta, Ecuador, St. Catherine University. Grace Eng, Edmonton, Alberta, Canada, University of Alberta. Sila Fadness, Austin, Minnesota, Hamline University. Gia Fisher, Great Falls, Montana, Montana State University. Jake Fisher, Great Falls, Montana, Montana State University. Logan Flaherty, Maple Grove, Minnesota, University of Notre Dame. Miguel Garcia Lopez, De Guayado, Jalisco, Mexico, University of Minnesota, Twin Cities. Sarah Gilbert, Prior Lake, Minnesota, University of Minnesota, Twin Cities. Mitchell Haberman, Owatonna, Minnesota, University of Minnesota, Twin Cities. Kimberly Hart, Roseville, Minnesota, University of Minnesota, Twin Cities. Brady Hartman, Buffalo, Minnesota, University of St. Thomas. Sarah Henry, St. Anthony, Minnesota, University of Minnesota, Twin Cities. Maddie Henches, New Brighton, Minnesota, Concordia University. Preston Herforth, Montevideo, Minnesota, South Dakota State University. Alexander Holm, Elk River, Minnesota, Winona State University. Archita Jane, Vaughan, Ontario, Canada, York University. Jeffrey Jansen, Crane Lake, Minnesota, University of Wisconsin, La Crosse. Isa Javed, Eau Claire, Wisconsin, University of Wisconsin-Madison. Cole Johnson, Thief River Falls, Minnesota, University of North Dakota. Mariah Johnson, Stuartville, Minnesota, University of St. Thomas. Stuart Jones, Circle Pines, Minnesota, University of Minnesota, Twin Cities, St. Paul College. Hallie Jordan, Detroit Lakes, Minnesota, Concordia College. Miriam Kella, Cairo, Egypt, University of Minnesota, Twin Cities. Hashayar Hodadustan, Esfahan, Iran, University of Minnesota, Twin Cities. Chloe Kinney, Lone Rock, Wisconsin, University of Wisconsin-Madison. Maya Chelberg, New Ulm, Minnesota, Concordia College. Ty Klein, Fisher, Minnesota, University of North Dakota. Kaylee Koski, Princeton, Minnesota, Concordia College. Austin Kotke, New Prague, Minnesota, St. John's University. Sophia Larson, Racine, Wisconsin, St. Norbert College. Dat Le, Nha Dinh, Vietnam, University of Minnesota, Twin Cities. Heian Lee, Cottage Grove, Minnesota, University of Minnesota, Twin Cities. Ryan Lemke, Chaska, Minnesota, St. John's University. Ivy Lynn, Monticello, Minnesota, University of Minnesota, Twin Cities. Samuel McKinney, Hastings, Minnesota, University of Minnesota, Duluth. Peyton McQuinn, La Crescent, Minnesota, University of Wisconsin, Stout. The following student is unable to join us today. Eric Mellon, Grand Forks, North Dakota, Princeton University. Stephanie Meyer, Cassin, Minnesota, Luther College. Kiefer Miller, Nevis, Minnesota, Concordia College. Roland Milutinovich, Chicago, Illinois, University of Illinois, Chicago. Tanmay Mishra, Calgary, Alberta, Canada, University of Western Ontario. Hannah Moen, Nisswa, Minnesota, College of St. Benedict. Matthew Moen, Eden Prairie, Minnesota, University of Minnesota, Twin Cities. Benjamin Montemp, Edina, Minnesota, University of Missouri, Columbia. Benjamin Moore, Ironwood, Michigan, Brigham Young University. Kayla Nelson, East Grand Forks, Minnesota, University of North Dakota. An No, Minneapolis, Minnesota, University of Minnesota, Twin Cities. Andrew Nguyen, Seattle, Washington, University of Washington. Michael Nguyen, San Diego, California, San Diego State University. not as easy as it looks, is it, everybody? No. Stephen Nguyen, North York, Ontario, Canada, University of Western Ontario. Jack Nierenhausen, Cross Lake, Minnesota, University of St. Thomas. Dylan Oborski, Buffalo, Minnesota, Montana State University. Margarita Osolovsky, Utica, New York, Metropolitan State University. Nicole Polly, Rochester, Minnesota, St. Olaf College. Juan Perez, Vero Beach, Florida, University of Miami. Vian Reyes, Windsor, Ontario, Canada, University of Windsor. Nadim Rashid, Burlington, Ontario, Canada, Western University. Riley Raskob, Maple Grove, Minnesota, University of Minnesota, Duluth. Paige Reiners, Stillwater, Minnesota, Gustavus Adolphus College. Alan Repack, West Fargo, North Dakota, North Dakota State University. Jason Ruprecht, Matamidi, Minnesota, University of Minnesota, Twin Cities. Tyler Schmidt, Cedar Falls, Iowa, Minnesota State University, Mankato. Destiny Schmitz, Farmington, Minnesota, University of Minnesota, Duluth. Megan Schooley, Bloomfield Hills, Michigan, Michigan State University. Jude Severson, Deerwood, Minnesota, Benedictine College. Vanessa Shinwin, Bamenda, Cameroon, University of Minnesota, Twin Cities. Mohammed Reza Shirmast, Tehran, Iran, Washington University in St. Louis. Hanina Singer, St. Louis Park, Minnesota, University of Minnesota, Twin Cities. Parker Smith, Selins Grove, Pennsylvania, University of Pittsburgh. Jisoo Song, Halifax, Nova Scotia, Canada, University of Western Ontario. Michael Stikos, Sarasota, Florida, Florida State University. Tanner Steinmetz, Medina, Minnesota, Bethel University. Matthew Takahashi, Sturgis, South Dakota, St. John's University. Alexa Tatarin, Plymouth, Minnesota, Loyola University, Chicago. Jacqueline Thomas, Eota, Minnesota, University of St. Thomas. Andrew Van Erp, Battle Lake, Minnesota, St. John's University. Corey Vang, Woodbury, Minnesota, Metropolitan State University. Mai Pang Vang, St. Paul, Minnesota, University of Minnesota, Twin Cities. Wei Wong, Guangzhou, China, St. Olaf College. Mua Kong Zhang, Wausau, Wisconsin, University of Wisconsin-Madison. Doris Zhang, Markham, Ontario, Canada, McGill University. Jeffrey Zhao, New Jersey, University of California, Los Angeles. James Jung, Madison, Wisconsin, University of Michigan, Ann Arbor. Welcome to the profession. Let's give them all a round of applause.
Take a minute and just say a big congratulations to each of you for entering this profession. As I'm sitting here, it dawned on me something unique about each of you in that you entered the profession during the pandemic. Things changed tremendously, and you guys were resilient, and you marched in, and you adapted. And you continue to move through in a different environment than most of us up here can even begin to imagine from your side of the equation. So I just want to give a big shout out to you all and all the things that you're going to accomplish in our great profession. I'd like the DDS class to stand with me while we recite the oath to the new dentist. In the tradition of Hippocrates and the men and women through the ages who have dedicated their lives to the art and science of medicine and dentistry, I make the following pledge. The respect and dignity of patients and the confidential nature of our relationship are foremost in my service to them. I acknowledge my limitations and need for continued education. I will seek the knowledge and inspiration of my colleagues, friends, and patients. My work shall be dedicated to improving the quality of life for those who seek my assistance. I will honor the wishes and needs of the patient and will always communicate treatment plans in the best interest of the patient. I will do no harm. I will strive always to improve the practice of dentistry, to provide a level of care that is ethical, moral, and just. I expect the same standards from my colleagues and will not tolerate their indifference, greed, or unethical behavior. My profession is an honored one. I will not violate the trust society has placed in me by allowing race, religion, sexual orientation, gender, disability, or social standing to affect my judgment or ability to take care of patients. I will be humble. I will consider the tools of my profession to be knowledge, skill, compassion, and patience. I will share these tools freely with my colleagues and patients alike. I shall do my utmost to provide the vulnerable members of society the care and attention they need to assure their health, dignity, and protection. I see all human life as sacred. In the presence of my teachers, my family, and my friends, I make these promises solemnly and freely. With this oath, I willingly assume the rewards and responsibilities of a dentist. Thank you.
Thank you again, Dr. Mays. It is now my great pleasure to introduce this afternoon's keynote speaker, Dr. Rachel Upgard. Dr. Upgard is a clinical associate professor in the Division of Oral and Maxillofacial Surgery here at the School of Dentistry. In addition to this role, she is a practicing oral and maxillofacial surgeon, is involved with multiple professional organizations, and also serves on the University Senate and the Educational Policy Committee. Please join me in giving a warm welcome to Dr. Upgard.
Thank you. Dental students, dental therapy students, dental hygiene students, and esteemed faculty, welcome. I am humbled to stand before you today to congratulate you on this important milestone in your professional journey and to encourage you to strive for greatness each and every day. After a year at the University of Minnesota, in the middle of a pandemic, we can finally honor your commitment to this opportunity of a lifetime to serve others through the work of your hands and through your brilliant minds. Today you put on a white coat, a coat that symbolizes the commitment to your chosen profession, to the practice of dentistry, to your colleagues, to your community, and most of all, to your patients. And while this coat comes off at the end of the day, your responsibility to the aforementioned do not. As you continue your journey to become a dental professional, you will learn how to perform procedures, how to administer local anesthesia, how to treat and hopefully prevent disease. And while in the next few years these procedures may seem daunting, what you will ultimately find is that it's the procedures themselves that are the easy part, and the communications and interactions that are so vitally important and yet so challenging. I want to take a moment and honor the work you have done so far. You are thriving in the midst of a pandemic, in an educational environment that we have worked together to create on the go. None of us thought we would be here, or that we would be working through the constraints of physical distancing and personal protective equipment on a new level. It hasn't always been easy, but what amazes me is how our students have worked with us as faculty to strive for excellence in learning and in education. We are proud of your resilience and enthusiasm for dentistry. Your professionalism as you approach this different learning environment does not go unnoticed, and your participation in your education at this time is paving the way for us to continue to improve how we educate our students. Many of you may have realized by now that dentistry is a profession that you will work on, learn in, and grow with every single day. That's why they call it practicing dentistry. As you begin your practice, you will find that there are so many different ideas and resources out in the world. We live in a world of social media with beautifully curated photos at every turn. These photos may put some healthcare professionals on a pedestal. I would challenge you to look past these images and to put your patients on this figurative pedestal instead. Make the patient and communicating with them the center of your work, and the rest will fall into place. Know that unlike the Instagram pages or TikTok videos we are exposed to, real life and the practice of this profession are sometimes messy and often hard. Strive for perfection, but understand that in life and in working with humans, few things are truly perfect. As a surgeon, I have procedures that don't go exactly the way that I want. Complications happen to all of us, and we have to work through the aftermath. Recognize your own weaknesses. For me, an example of this is that sometimes I find my attempts to communicate with other professionals come across as aggressive when I mean for them to be passionate in the support of the best care for the patients. I have to take a step back and make sure I'm working well as a team player. Despite the best of intentions, I stand up in front of you today and can tell you from experience that as long as you are working with humans and as long as you are a human, you will fall short. The only people who don't have complications are those who do nothing. On the days you fall short, remember that we all fall short. Pick yourself up, dust yourself off, do everything you can to make the situation better, and learn from it. Rely on your colleagues and friends, and be there for them when they need someone. One of the biggest things I learned from my classmates after we graduated is how much we need each other. We are perfectionists living in a world of humanity. At the end of the day, your ability to communicate with your patients, to learn from your shortcomings, and to connect with other professionals is what will help you sleep at night. Extend grace to others. Life is hard. Going to the dentist is hard. In the words of Brené Brown, everyone has a story or struggle that will break your heart. And if we are really paying attention, most people have a story that will bring us to our knees. Your patients, colleagues, and team members don't come with a blueprint that lets you know what they are suffering from. Challenges ranging from financial stress to infertility to loss of loved ones, from health stressors, relationship issues, to food insecurity, the impact of racism, and so many other challenges may be hidden. Reach out to your colleagues and check in. This can be as simple as a phone call, text message, or email. It could be a smile or asking how you can help. Extend that grace to your patients as well. The physiologic and psychologic manifestations of these stressors may be all you see and may be what complicate your ability to treat these patients. Listening, taking a step back, and taking the time for your patient to feel heard can be just as important as the procedure you perform. Remember that prioritizing your patients doesn't mean neglecting yourself and your well-being. You cannot care for others if you are falling apart on the inside. Find ways to recharge your batteries. For me, that's going for a run or getting outside with my kids and my dogs. It's having a conversation with my partner about what I'm going through or connecting with my colleagues to get their perspectives. In class, many of you shared with me the activities that help you stay balanced, whether it's going outside or painting, spending time with family, friends, and what sounds like a lot of dogs, and exercise. Continue to connect with the people and activities that fill you with joy. Care for your community as well. This education is the greatest gift you will ever receive. Take advantage of it. Give back to your community. The need here is in our own state is so great, and it extends beyond. Go to Hope Dental Clinic or Sharing and Caring Hands. Find a way to give of your talents, especially through using your specialized skills. To close, I'd like to challenge you to the following activity. If you would like, I want you to close your eyes and bring to the front of your mind a photo that's on your phone of a loved one or loved ones that you would be excited about sharing with others. These are your picture people, or could be your picture pets. They bring you joy and you care about them. as you approach patient care, on those days that you have a patient whose behavior is a challenge, I want you to remember that the patient in your chair is someone else's picture person. Treat them as such, even when it's hard. Atul Gawande, a surgeon who writes on how we can improve inpatient care, states that no matter what measures are taken, doctors will sometimes falter, and it isn't reasonable to ask that we achieve perfection. What is reasonable is to ask that we never cease to aim for it. Go out there and never stop trying. We can't wait to see what you accomplish. Thank you.
Thank you for that inspiring message, Dr. Upgard. I would like to thank our student speakers and Dr. Upgard for their participation in today's ceremonies. And to all the families, friends, guests, and faculty who were able to attend today's ceremony online. As the case with so many events of this magnitude, it's impossible to celebrate our great students without the generous gifts from our friends. We gratefully acknowledge Dr. Freeman and Mrs. Shirley Rosenblum and the Upper Midwest section of the American College of Dentists for their generous support of today's event. Students, please join me in a round of applause for Dr. and Mrs. Rosenblum and the Upper Midwest section of the American College of Dentists. Thank you again to everyone who joined us today, online and in person, and to our Dental Therapy Class of 2023, Dental Hygiene Class of 2022, and Doctor of Dental Surgery Class of 2024, welcome to the profession. I was just sitting here thinking how, first of all, I'm so glad we got to honor you all today, of course, we wouldn't have missed this. And it's so cool, actually, that you know each other now for a year. You got to go through this meaningful experience together, already having these great friendships and this sense of camaraderie. So I just want to encourage you to go out today, take some pictures. Remember this exciting feeling, because as we've all mentioned, there will be days when you think, oh my goodness, what have I gotten myself into? This is so challenging. And if you can just remember that you're all in this together and you've always got a colleague that you can call and chat with and they'll say, oh my gosh, I just had the same thing happen to me. It'll make you feel a little bit better and that sense of camaraderie will really take you far. So I hope you celebrate each other safely and go out and take some photos on this beautiful day to remember this moment. I would like to thank Anna Sontag and the Office of Student and Resident Affairs for making this event possible at all, making it so organized and so special. And thank you to everyone for joining us today.